Welcome back to Data Structure Laboratory. In today's class, let us see 5th B lab program, that is solving a Tower of Hanoi problem with N-Disk. First, let us understand what is Tower of Hanoi problem. We will have three towers, Tower A, B and C. Tower A is a source, Tower C is a destination. Now, we will have N disks given. What is this problem is? We have to move all these N disks in such a way that the first condition is when you are moving it from source to destination, you have to move only one disk at a time. Second condition is when you are moving it at any instance, you have to ensure that smaller disk will be always kept on top of bigger disk. So basically for Tower of Hanoi, there are two conditions. The first condition is, what is objective is, you are going to move all these N disk from A to C. While moving, you have two conditions. Only one disk you have to move at a time, and smaller disk should be always kept on top of bigger disk. So with these two conditions, you have to solve this problem, right? So to understand this problem, which is more complicated, we also call it as NP hard problem. Whenever N keeps on increasing, this problem becomes most complicated to solve, and the time complexity of this problem is 2 to the power N minus 1, which is very, very complex, right? Which is very, very time consuming. So to understand this problem, I'll just take two instances. Let us say N equal to 1. When N is equal to 1, how many disks will be there? Only one disk. So what program is meant to do? What program can do? It can move the first disk from Tower A to Tower C. So only one operation will be executed if N is equal to 1. When N is 2, there will be two disks. Top disk we call it as first disk, bottom disk is second disk, right? So whenever N is 2, the first operation we do is move N minus 1th disk from Tower A to Tower B recursively. So once you move topmost disk, we are left with only one disk, which is bottom disk. What we do, we will move it from Tower A to Tower C. After moving it, the last operation is we will take the N minus 1th disk, which is already there in the Tower B, and move it to the Tower C. Correct? So having understood how to solve this problem for N equal to 1 and N equal to 2, let us start with the program now. So we will not understand for other values of N. When N becomes 3, there are basically 7 different movements. When N becomes 4, it becomes 15 different operations. So when N keeps on increasing, this problem becomes more and more complicated. But it is easy to understand when N is equal to 1 and N is equal to 2. Having understood how to solve it for smaller values of N, let us directly start with the program now. We have one user-defined function. The name of that function is tower. Return type is void. It will take four arguments. First one is int. Int means what? What is N value? So in our case, N value is 2. Char, char and char. So the first char is source. Second char is a destination. Third char is temporary tower, right? So we will have N value and address of three different towers. So start with the main program. When you compile and run this program, it will ask enter number of disk. I'll just say N equal to 2, right? Okay, then it will say sequence of movements involved in Tower of Hanoi R. It will call towers. The first argument is 2, remaining three arguments A comma C comma B. A is a source, C is a destination, and B is a temporary tower, correct? So when you, the moment you call towers function, control will come back to this line. It will start executing this recursive function. See how it executes, right? So this we call it as from peg, to peg, and auxiliary peg. Okay, what is the first argument? A. Second argument C. Third argument is B. So A will come and sit here, B will come to next argument, and C will come to next argument. Now check whether num is equal to 1. Do we have num equal to 1? No. If you have only one disk, what this program will do is it will just print move disk 1 from percentage C to percentage C. What is a variable values you have specified? From peg to peg. What is from peg? A. What is to peg? It is C. So when you have only one disk, the problem is very, very simple. It will just print one printf statement, that's it, correct? And it will stop. But in our case, n value is 2. So this condition will not hold good. It will come here. It calls towers n minus 1 from peg, auxiliary peg, to peg. What is this is, whenever I have two disk, n minus 1th disk should be moved from tower A to tower B by using destination tower, that is C, as a temporary location. So when I call this towers function, once again control comes back here, num is 1. So in this place we have A, here we have B, here we have C. What is num value? 1. So it will print something like, we have moved first disk from tower A to tower B, correct? Now after completion of execution of this recursive function, we'll go for next line. Next line says, see, what is the next movement we have to do? Already first disk is moved from A to B, correct? Now the next operation we have to do is move disk percentage D from peg percentage C to peg percentage C. So here we have given an argument as num. Num value is 2. So it will print move disk 2 from A to tower C. Correct? So what this recursive function has done, it has just moved the topmost disk from source to temporary tower. And this printf statement has moved the last disk from source to destination tower, correct? So we are left with last operation, call the same towers function on n minus 1, move from auxiliary peg to destination peg, correct? So the same, whenever the control comes here, a control comes back here, num is 1, from peg is auxiliary peg, you can see here. The second argument is auxiliary peg. Here it becomes a from peg. Then to peg is destination peg. And then this becomes a temporary needle. So num is equal to 1. It just prints move disk 1 from auxiliary peg to destination peg. So it will print something like move disk 1 from tower B to tower C. That's it. So this is how Tower of Hanoi can be implemented. This is a recursive function, and only through recursion we can solve this problem. And this problem becomes complicated when n keeps on increasing. So what we have done is we have tried to simplify it. We know how to find a solution for n equal to 1, how to find a solution for n equal to 2. According to that, we have implemented this program. Thank you so much.